Hello friends, welcome back. In this video we'll see the basic terms that are being used in JMS. You can call them like JMS elements or components or basic terminology. Okay, so let's begin the video and let's see what do we have today. Okay, so as I told you earlier, JMS is an API. It's like a complete package, a complete set of Java classes, right? And we have seen in the past couple of videos what can be done with the JMS, and we know the basic purpose of JMS as well. If you haven't seen the last couple of videos, I would request you guys to go through those videos. You will have a basic like a good understanding of JMS and what are the major advantages of using JMS. But in this video we are going to talk about JMS components or elements, like what are the things are there in the JMS. Okay, so let's see. First of all, we have something called Java JMS client. So client is nothing, it's just a Java piece of code, a Java program. Yes, Java client is nothing, a Java class, a Java program. Now you can make use of this client as Java program to send a message or to receive a message. So it depends. For example, you have two different applications, or within the same application you can create a client you can create a client to send a message to application B, and in application B there also you can create a Java client, a Java program that can be used to consume or receive the message. Now basic intention of this is to understand the terms. So when you say a program that is used to send or produce or publish, because like there are people they call it this Java program will publish a message, right, or will produce or will send a message. So these terms, right, these are different terms, but the sense is it's gonna be a program that will generate a message for you guys. Okay, and then we have receive or consume or subscribe. So there are people who say like my program, part of application B, it should be able to consume or it should subscribe to the messages from the application A. So the term receive, consume and subscribe stands for a Java program that is going to receive the message or read the message for you guys. I hope you're clear so far. So here we saw a sender, as that is Java program to send, to produce, to publish, same thing. Receive, consume and subscribe, same thing. Okay, now let's see what is a JMS sender. So JMS sender, again a client program that is used to send messages to a destination from application A to application B. So this program is known as JMS sender. We also call it JMS provider or a publisher. Sorry, producer or a publisher. So who is publisher? Publisher is the program that is responsible to publish the message on the topic or on the queue. So basically a Java program that will publish, that will produce or send a message to the destination. So producer, publisher, JMS sender is same thing. That's one thing only. The next we have JMS receiver. So again, receiver is a Java client that receives messages from the source system. Now this system, JMS receiver, you can call it JMS consumer because it consumes the message, or JMS subscriber because it subscribes the message. If there are messages in the queue and I am the subscriber, means I will receive those messages. Say for example an application A is producing different set of messages, 10 type of messages, but there can be people who just want 2 messages only out of 10. There are other people who just want 5 messages out of 10. So basically you have subscribed, like I have subscribed to receive 2 messages out of 10. So I am a subscriber, right? So JMS receiver, JMS consumer or JMS subscriber is the same thing, it's one thing. Then we have JMS provider. So a provider is the one who provides the services. it's like a third party. Like if I talk about Apache MQ and WebSPN MQ, Active MQ, Web Methods MQ, MQ Alliance. So there are many third party providers in the market. So basically they provide some sort of adapters, some sort of softwares or you can say softwares or utilities through which you can control the entire thing, or you can administrate or control this message oriental middleware. So JMS provider is like a third party. So we'll discuss like what are the or who are the main providers in the industry. We'll see maybe in this video or in the coming videos. Okay, so here we have a few more. We have something called JMS administered objects. So what is this? It's like JMS objects which are pre-configured by the administrators for the use of JMS clients. They are connection factory and destination object. So administrator object includes connection factory and destination object. So connection factory is the one who is responsible to create the connection with the client, and destination is responsible for the channel. So you will understand these things better in the Java program. The time when we will learn how to code in JMS. So I will give you more idea about these two things, connection factory and destination. These two things are really, really important. So let's see what is connection factory. Connection factory object is used to create a connection between Java application and JMS provider. Right? So this is connection factory responsible to create the connection. It lets your Java program to create a connection with the JMS provider. So basically, how do we create? We'll see. We'll create some JNDI for that. So basically, it is used by application to communicate with the JMS provider. So there are two objects. One is connection factory. We saw this. It allows you your application code to communicate with the JMS provider. And then we have something called destination. So destination allows JMS objects used by a client to specify the destination of messages it is sending and the source of messages it receives. So basically, if I talk about a destination, destination is like connection factory. You understood, right? It just lets you create the connection between the provider and the Java application. Then we have destination. There we decide like where should you put this message. So that thing comes under destination. If you talk about destination, so there are two destinations. One is queue and one is topic. So what is queue and what is topic? We'll learn in the coming videos. Okay. And then next is JMS message. So message. So whatever the components we are here like more for the technical purpose. But yeah, you should have understanding of these. So JMS administered objects. So there are two things. One is connection factory. One is destination. Connection factory, we understood. Something which allows your application to create the connection with the JMS provider. Destination, way to deliver the message. Now, so there are two destinations. One is a queue and one is a topic. So I will explain what is queue and what is topic in the next video. And then JMS message. Message is just an object. So message is just like your message which you transfer from application 1 to application B. So we'll see, we'll talk about these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 things in the coming video, that too in detail. Okay, so guys, thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next videos.